These lanes.
Mid lane. Soul Gaming, yes.
TA just taking a bit of harass there, the cold snap. But she's got a bottle, she'll be fine.
Lion, yes, and
dewarding the sentry, they're not happy
Izzy,
about it.
Izzy, yes. Nah, he needed to do that, because they want to keep that equilibrium just at that spot there. It's right where the sentry was. So as long as they can keep that there, it looks like Clink's trying to maintain that. So keeping that area away from the sentries is absolutely fantastic for him. Lion, getting that 2 points in air spike, no mana drain yet. Normally we see the mana drain by level 3, at least.
Yeah, it could help against the constant spam that Silence is chucking out. It's actually going to go aggressively on
the
Silence.
Oh, the Silence are getting really low, but maybe they're going to... Oh, they actually deward that sentry with the Tango. That was... yeah, that was not looking good.
He's got another one, so they're probably going to try and get rid of this one too.
Oh, that Clink's getting really low. Do they have another sentry to drop down? He just needs a few more hits, but he is going to run away. He does not actually drop. He did use his stick, and he survived, even though he was arcane cursed. He would have died there, so it was good that he had the magic stick. Magic wand, that is, rather. Doom still farming uncontested in the jungle here. He's got his boots, he's got a smoke, so it looks like he could be ready to make a gank. He does have a war stomp stun he can use, which is very nice. He has not got Infernal Blade just yet, which is completely fine.
Yeah, he probably wants to get this TA.
But he can definitely get a kill here. Not level 6 just yet, but that's fine. He does
Invoker.
Have
he was already doing very well.
And Disruptor also picking up a smoke. So both heroes actually on the same page. He's got a ward and a smoke to get here, so they could look to get some sort of kill. And Slark just farming away again. He's going for a very interesting skill build here. This is the skill build I normally get unhappy with whenever I see people do this. The Max Dark Pact build. What do you think of the Max
farming.
Dark Pact build?
It's good for farming, especially if they're stacking as well, but it doesn't look like they are. But yeah, you don't underestimate the damage. It's 300 at level 4, which is huge. Especially against a Tidehunter. Those right clicks aren't going to do a whole lot against anyway.
You know what? I actually think that that build is only viable when you are doing well in lane. For sure. You can't really sustain that level of Dark Pact. It does... he does only take 50% of damage, but it's still a lot. And he does have treads now, so I guess that's
Clink's
understandable.
Mid lane,
but,
looking for TA. Goes a bit too early there, I think. Invoker wasn't quite ready.
Clink's not having a good game, Mads. Look at this last hit distribution here. Slark at 30 with 15 denies, but Clink's 14 and 1 deny.
Yeah, this aggressive dual lane is working out for them quite nicely. It's not something you would expect.
No.
Like, even after the draft, we were unsure of what was happening.
Oh, hang on, the mid lane, Mads. A glimpse has come through the Evoker. Does he have anything like Ghostwalk? He is getting taken down really quick. The minus armor doing a lot here. He's got a fairy fire used. He's got the ice wall. One more attack.
The
TA is going to find him. She's just running around in circles and does find him.
Evoker dropping to the forge.
Oh, we've missed something
there.
Here. The Slark finding another kill.
And Slark killing Tide again. Showing the power of that Dark Pact build that he can blow up the Tidehunter solo.
I honestly, I never really liked that build, but in this situation, if it works well for him, then that's good at least.
Yeah, I mean, like, the Pounce also does a bit of damage, but just not as much. And the Essence Shift, he's not going to get a huge amount of hits off in this 1v1 scenario, so it's more for a farming orientated build, I think. Like you said, he's doing well, so he can afford to...
Yeah, normally if you're not doing too well, you want to max that Pounce. The cooldown scales really well, the distance scales really well. It's just great for escaping, but if they haven't really rotated on him, I think he just doesn't really need it, does he? But, top lane, this is some aggression from Doom. He's used that smoke we talked about. He does have level 6.
He's got the Doom.
And he could use it on someone. He's going to get spotted out by the creeps. He's going to run onto the Silencer. Silencer's going to get doomed, and he's actually going to get chased down. There's no follow-up, though. Stun from Ogre. The Sunstrike though, does it hit? It does connect. And he's going to keep diving this by the looks of it. He's going to keep going. He just wants that damage from that burn, that passive burn there.
Yeah,
and he's very low and he will go down in the end.
Doom is now in a tough spot. TA is rotating around.
Doom could devour one of these creeps. There's rotations coming in. He might want to devour just before he dies. And he does, so he does get his money worth here. and the meld missing just a little bit
away here.
And everyone's here. The whole team's rotated. This is not looking good for them at all. And this Ogre and this TA have actually... This is the only one left there. She does meld. And she does take down the Klinks.
Takes the Klinks with her. Disruptor wants some too. He might get this kill. He's going to get a kill on Doom. It's definitely worth it. Nice play from Disruptor.
Right, I didn't even notice that. That is very unfortunate for Doom.
Well, that was an interesting scuffle there. Pretty even in terms of net worth shift, so just a bit of fun from both teams.
Yes. I think that definitely. I think that just went the way of Salt Can't Melt Steel Beams again, though. Simply because Klinks is dying. Klinks is dying a lot.
Yeah, Klinks is very low in the net worth charts. He's below halfway, so it's not where you want your Klinks. It's hard for him to catch up without kills.
It is. Klinks is such a good hero at getting kills. He hasn't got level 6 yet. And Klinks is all about getting level 6. And he's
actually
going to
run on
them
here. They've got the
sentry. They're going to do heaps of damage here. The Ignite and the Glaives of Wisdom proving to be very, very painful. And they're just going to try and run away here. There is a rotation from the Lion. Can they actually do anything? This Global Silence coming out.
I've got the Ravage.
And they're
going to
chase him down. They've got the Ravage, but he's been stunned up here. He does use it in the end. And the Silencer has got nowhere to run. They do not have Doom. They don't need it. And they take him down. Arcane Curse. And they're actually
gonna
keep going to
get Ogre too. Slack is going up, though.
That is a very nice ult from the Disruptor. He's silencing both of those heroes, and they're going to get picked off here. Salt Can't Melt Steel Beams, but Invoker TPing in, but what can he do? I mean, he is by himself, with the Tide, no Ravage, and just Forge Spirit. Just going to try and keep these creeps away from the tower. Don't want to lose that, but as we saw, the Klinks has rotated bot and is trying his best to farm.
Yeah, Klinks just wanted none of that. He just wants to farm in peace, but like, just showing that the Ogre and Silencer can just run under the tower and get a free kill on him, so it's going to be a tough game for him.
And we see the typical Disruptor build here, maxing the Glimpse. I think that is always the way to go. Are you like me and you sort of get a little bit unhappy when people decide to neglect the Glimpse and leave one point in it?
I hate that. That's like half the reason you even pick the heroes for that ability.
Oh, it's definitely.
I think leaving Kinetic Field at level 1 is fine.
For sure.
Because the duration doesn't scale that well, and usually like it's better to be able to catch them out and hold them for a little bit than not be able to catch them out at all.
Yes, and the mid lane, TA. They were sort of looking to go on the TAT, being a little bit defensive here. He does use the Skeleton Walk again, and he doesn't have treads though. I think Klinks really needs treads ASAP. This TA, she knows something's up. She's playing a little bit defensive here, and there's nothing they can do about it. They're kind of wasting the time of pulling forehead here.
Well, Klinks, he's not going to catch up by farming, so I think this is the right play to try and look for kills.
Yeah, it is.
Because he just farms so slowly.
But he needs to be successful in these rotations.
This Invoker is doing so well. He's got the Midas as well. So he's solidified his position in number one on the net worth. He's doing very well.
He has, yes. He is ahead of the TA by over 1,000 net worth.
Silencer and Ogre going to catch out Doom in the jungle. You get the stun off.
Oh, we were missing that one. Oh, that is a very nice cross damage. He actually cancels his animation of his Doom, and he's going to silence up. They're going to take him down before he gets the Doom off, and they do take him in the end. The Lion wants to get a kill here. He has level 6, and he's being stunned up here. He might actually use it on the Ogre, but Ogre's going to get taken down by Invoker here. Just focus down. He doesn't actually need to use the Finger of Death. And actually saves it. Klinks had double damage that time, though.
So a 2-for-1 there. Probably not worth it for Salt there. Just getting the Doom. Those two heroes. I guess they just didn't expect the whole team to be nearby.
Right, that was an interesting fight for sure. Really good rotations from both teams.
Slark finishing his Shadow Blade. This is a very quick Shadow Blade, so in about the 12 minute mark.
Yes. No, that is very quick. And he could even look to try and pressure this tower. There's no one really defending it. They do have a Fortify, but might decide to use it here. But he has gone untested. And he's even got his own dust here, so he is definitely wanting to get some kills very soon.
Yeah, if he finds the clinks, that's a free kill for him, just by himself.
Yeah, Clinks has level 3 skeleton walk. He does move fairly quickly here, but he is so easy to take down. I mean, they are looking to get a kill top here. The silencer, he's going to get cold snapped, and he's actually going to get burst down by the Clinks here. Very quick damage, and he's actually dominating on the invoker here, getting the kill instead of the Clinks. Clinks may have needed that a bit more than the invoker.
Yeah, but that's what we were talking about. He needs these kills, and yeah, he's doing a good job rotating around the map and not just sticking in his jungle.
Oh, hang on, Mads, we are missing some very exciting stuff down bottom. Lion getting a double kill. We did miss that.
So the Doom was dropped for that?
Yes, the Doom was used, but the Lion ult was not. There was a cold snap, there was some Forge Spirits as well, most likely Meteors.
Yeah, Doom's such a great pick against Slark.
Yeah, I think it's one of the best picks against Slark here. TA is by herself in the jungle there. She's got the blink dagger now, so she's got some escape, and she sees these
needs
guys
to be
here.
Careful,
she's definitely
yeah.
gonna be very careful. Radiant they're not really gonna go on her, I don't think. It's possible that they're worried about other people being there. But this bottom tower,
they do have rotations coming in.
They're actually doing the wraparound here. They're kind of just leaving the jungle now. Both groups of heroes here, just leaving. Pulling forehead, don't really want to get too deep in there because they have not got much vision. They actually do have a ward here, scouting out a few things, actually. It's a very nice ward. And they're going to smoke. They are smoked here. They are pinging out the ward here. Whether they saw that or not, I actually didn't see where they exact spot of where they smoked. They need to smoke just on the other side of these trees here.
Would have been close.
But I mean, they could find the invoker, but they're actually going to go through mid. They are going to try the jungle, and they do have the uphill advantage. Lion does have the uphill advantage here, and they are going to spot him out. The glimpse coming in already. He's going to get straight back into that, and he is going to get bursted down. Not really the person you want to get in a smoke gank, unfortunately, but still.
Yeah, it's better than nothing, you know.
It is better than nothing, yes, indeed. And who got the kill there? It was Silencer. Okay, and it was a killing spree. I guess he was a bit of a target. And Invoker just using that creep. and Slark just running away. He's farming fairly well, though. We look at net worth. He is second. And he's actually a fair bit behind the Invoker, though. Invoker's just snowballed in terms of net worth here. Probably because of the Hand of Midas he's gone for.
Just want to say thanks for the donation there from Cacti King. Always appreciate it.
Yes, thank you for that, Cacti King. I love the name, by the way.
Silencer, interesting position here.
He is going to get cold snapped. He is going to get very, very, very dead at this point here. And there's
nice
a disruptor ultimate catching out a couple of heroes here. And the Ogre Magi is getting very low. He's actually just getting down by the clinks in the end there. And Invoker is by himself here. He's going to get caught out. He's going to get focused down by Slark. And the disruptor going down as well. There's lots of even trades going on. Slark wants to chase him down, but does he have the mana? Does he have the momentum? Could go after this Tidehunter. This Tidehunter's in a bad spot. He hasn't got any money, he has no blink.
Lion's the Lion on the back side of that one.
I didn't see that. Where is TA? Right here. Okay.
It was just below the tier 3 there. She was very deep. But that blink dagger, hard to escape from.
TA gonna fill up her bottle here with the Invis rune. And Silencer just going back to farm. He's going for the Orchid. So
that was a 3-for-3.
Yeah.
But because the Invoker died, that was a big upset for pulling ahead there, because he was on a streak.
Yeah, he was on a streak. 471 gold for the Slark. It was a dominating streak, so 4 kills just put to an end there. And the Clinks, though, has actually got 3 kills now, so he went from going like 0-2 or 0-3 to 3-for-4 now, and 3 assists, so he's catching up here, and this is good for him.
Still got a lot of work to do.
Still has a lot of work to do. He's behind the Doom, he's behind the Silencer, and obviously the Doom's on his own team, but the Doom actually does have a drum here, and he's ready to battle. And he's got a nice ultimate which he can use on this Slark next fight. But then it looks like there could be a fight down bottom here. They want to push Disruptor here. He's got his sentries.
TA wrapping around. She's got the invis.
Whether she actually get to kill here on the Tidehunter. Yeah. Looks like Tidehunter actually going to commit to this camp here. They are pinging it out. But there is an invoker close by. Whether they actually do anything, the TA's actually gone on him. She's used the meld. She's going to use meld again probably very soon. She does actually blink to do this, and he has got lots of minus armor here. Well, he doesn't anymore, but he is going to get taken down. Arcane Curse! Will it take him down? Look at this. 2 HP, and he goes down.
And meanwhile,
that was...
I missed that. To the team catch out the invoker, they get him trapped in a static storm, so...
Well,
showing that power of that disruptor pick against him as well.
I was following that kill on Tidehunter because that was some real clutch gaming right there. He was so low and he did go down just... he had one or two more ticks of the Arcane Curse and he would have survived, but he did die in the end.
We had TPs up. But...
Mid lane, just a bit of a casual glimpse there for the Doom. He's going to pop his Scorched Earth here and run back to base with a TP. I am missing a couple of things here, unfortunately. Clink's getting 2 points of strafe now.
Picking up another form of silence there. So, another ability that just helps out against these heroes like Invoker, who just rely on their spells. I mean, pretty much the majority of pulling ahead relies on their spells.
Yeah.
Even Clinks to a certain extent.
Tidehunter, Invoker, I think these are some really good heroes to use Orchid on. If you really want to just get that, once the team fight starts, and if you're in a good position, you're probably even worth like Orchiding the Tidehunter and just delaying that Ravage, you know, because the Ravage into like a Meteors, just, you know, to Deafening Blasts, it's not something you want, and delaying the Ravage is pretty much always a good idea because that is what actually wins team fights a lot of times.
The thing is, Tide's going to get his Ravage off no matter what. He's so tanky that you just can't burst him down in the time that you can keep him silenced and locked down.
Yeah.
So I'd say it's probably more for picking off heroes like the Clinks or Invoker. So we've just had tier 1 taken by pulling ahead, and they do have heroes on this bottom lane, but looks like they might be trading for this top tier 2, which they probably don't want to do.
Yeah, they are definitely pushing this. They want something, but everyone's rotating back.
The smoke
has been used. Doomin and Tidehunter smoked up here, and of course the Clinks as well. Not that he needs it, but he can actually use his death pack and still be invis, so that's good for him. But they are, they're just sort of hanging around the jungle. They know something's up. The Forge Spirit scouting people out. And this could be bad positioning by TA here, if they catch out TA, but lots of pings coming in on the Clinks, they know he's there. Slark, he's just waiting for him to come back to that sentry. And he actually is, but they are just going to back down to the low ground. Very awkward.
Stare off right now.
Very, very awkward stare off here. Lots of drawing on the map. An Ogre leading the charge, dewarding that, but the Courier actually being used there to deward on the cliff, but it didn't work out.
Looks like they're just going to back off, so...
Yeah, they're wasting time. Both teams are wasting time here if they're not going to get anything here. Clink's just going to go back to farming. He does actually, it looks like he's going for the Desolator or for the BKB. Probably the Desolator, which is what we normally see first.
I still would like to see that Orchid like we talked about. I think it would be so strong in this game.
Super strong. Whether they just decided that Silencer should be the only one to go for it. And that Sentry is not going to catch out the Sentry of Pauling Forehead. Attack. And Clink's strafing to take down that bottom tower.
Finishing off that tower.
He's got a
cheeky
double damage rune as well, and he actually is going for the Desolator here. He's got the second Mithril Hammer, and he has the finished recipe. And it looks like he could even get a pickoff on TA here if she's not careful. He does have a double damage rune he can use here.
He's got Lion in the neighborhood too.
Oh, there's three heroes available to help.
They might use
TA
for this.
They know she's here. They want to cancel this blink. They do have the Global Silence, and it is going to help her get away. They can't actually... They got to cancel this blink, and they do actually not really bother with it. This could be a bit of a turnaround here. Doom is getting taken down here. He's going to... Oh my god, I cannot decide who to focus on here. This Slark has got his BKB, but didn't even know he had this. And he is going to take down all of these heroes very quickly.
Massive
catching three heroes. And the Lion, very unlucky for him. Look how close he was to taking down this TA. How did TA not die there?
With that.
How did TA not die?
Refraction too strong. Some great play there from Salt. That static storm and the slight that BKB was... that he's just picked up as well. Does so much against the team. There's nothing they can do against him when he's got that on. Great.
No, I think this is 100% the item he should go for. And whereas Clinks can still hit him quite a lot, there is a it does pierce spell immunity. Is literally just gonna still be hitting very hard on the Clinks, but. The Slark, I mean, he is going to be invulnerable to the Lion disables, which he already was anyway with Dark Pact. He's going to be super hard to take down. He does have to worry about Doom though, of course, still.
It also means that he can go for solo pickoffs on Invoker as well, because he's just invulnerable against him pretty much when he's got that on.
Well, I mean, this is some another smoke. This is the third smoke we've seen in the last couple of minutes, I think. Doom and Clinks leading the way. Looking like they being a little bit too aggressive, possibly. They do actually initiate on the Disruptor. He's so...
Four hits,
but this is a nice initiation from Slark. He's actually going to get bursted down, though, with the Doom. The Doom is not available now, and the Ogre Magi is going to get really low here. Clinks obviously dying, but Ogre Magi is going to get chased down here. He is slowed by the Infernal Blade, and he's need one more attack, and he does go down.
Massive fight there.
That's four heroes. I didn't even see the rest of them die.
It's a great play from Clinks to start that off. He hit the high ground and they couldn't see him, so he couldn't be glimpsed. And that Desolator doing so much work. I think he killed the Disruptor in four hits.
Right. Yes. I'm sorry, I'm getting messages here about the stream. This is a Manta pickup for TA. What do you think of this Manta pickup in terms of rather than going for that damage or the BKB?
I'm not 100% on it, honestly. Maybe she was... I honestly don't know. I think I'd rather have seen a BKB or even a damage item like the Deso, but Manta's a little bit more defensive than I would like, especially in their position. They're doing quite well. What do you think she needs it to dispel, or she's just going for the general stats?
Normally no when silences. You get the Manta, yeah, normally you get it to dispel and for the good stats, and you don't generally always see the S and Y on a TA. So I think that it's definitely good for stats, but normally you don't get it until you want to sort of... Maybe until you've had like some damage or something. TA does hit hard naturally anyway, but the Manta is going to be good for purging off a few things. I can imagine you would purge off the Gush, you would purge off the Cold Snap, the Deafening Blast, what am I thinking? Yeah, Deafening Blast. But it's all situational, and I think it's... Well, actually, no, can you purge off the Disarm from Deafening Blast? I'm actually not sure. I don't think you can.
No, I don't think
no.
So.
No, so that's not
going to
work.
I don't think you can purge off Cold Snap either, right? It's Manta.
No, I think you can purge off Cold Snap, but definitely not Deafening Blast. I have a feeling you can. We'll have to have a look at that.
Yeah. Interesting pick. I mean, especially that we were just talking about how BKB is so strong this game for their team as well. She might still go for it, but then it leaves her not very scary in terms of damage. Although she is hitting pretty hard naturally, but... It'd be interesting to see in these next team fights.
Yep, for sure. And they are actually going to smoke up here. TA is just going to keep farming. She actually accidentally cancels that smoke, and she's going to have to keep going back to last hits. Disruptor leading the charge. He has that level 4 glimpse. Super big range. You can even make it even better with an Aether Lens if you really wanted to, or Aether Lens, however you want to pronounce it. And they are going into this mid lane looking for someone, but they're wrapping around. And they're pinging out the jungle, so they're gonna look for someone here. Bloodlust being popped here for the silencer. He's looking very tall now. And everyone's hiding, they're all TPing back. The Tidehunter, he knows something's up. He's got TP, he does have nearly a mech, 600 roughly gold away from that. And they are just gonna go back. It was a failed gank, unfortunately for them. But TA was farming for the majority of that, and so was Slark. His item progression has not been too good though since he got the BKB. I guess he does have 1600 gold.
Yeah, he's got a bit in the bank. I think he's probably going to go for possibly the Skadi now just let him tank up a little bit and hopefully survive a Doom if it gets dropped on him.
Yeah, the Doom, the Clink's arrows. I think Scotty's great against the Clink's. It really just makes him... He needs to go for some sort of... You know, he is actually going for the BKB here. I think this is absolutely the way he should go. The BKB is super important this game for Clink's.
This Invoker, though, picked up his eggs already, so... He's looking in a very, very nice position now, so we'll be seeing a lot of spells flying around from him in the next teamfight.
Oh yeah, look at that. He is, his last hits are ahead of everyone, his net worth is ahead of everyone, his items are fantastic. He has got a Midas that is yet to be used in terms of this current cooldown. I just want to see him use it. And he's gone for the Sunstrike just to see if he can see anyone in the Roche Pit. No one's in there, but... They know someone smoked. I mean, look at them all, you know, sort of hanging around here. They are waiting to find the enemy. They're pinging out. There's a sentry.
They're all hiding. They know what's happening.
Ogre Magi should be careful.
They're having a wee tree party over here.
Yes, Clinks is just going to use his... He probably could actually see if he can go do some scouting, see if he can find them. But both teams are sort of a little bit scared of what's happening here. No idea, probably... at the whereabouts of each of the teams. But Doom's farming, well, he looks like he's going for that BKB next, possibly. Now that he's got the drum and the blink. And Clink's checking the Roche Pit. They could even consider going for it. Looks like they are. Maybe not. Just dewarding the trap.
Yeah, I imagine this BKB is for the silence, so as soon as he gets silence, pop the BKB, and then you can freely use your Doom. But you need to remember not to use your BKB before the global silence comes out, because it does pierce spell immunity.
Yes, and this is something that the Disruptor needs to worry about. Looks like he would really need to go for an Aghanim's this game, since there are so many BKBs being picked up in this game, and Aghanim's would cancel the BKB anyway and would not allow him to use it. So I think I think Aghanim's Scepter and Disruptor is one of the best Aghanim's upgrades in the game.
But again, you're a position five, so
it does take a lot of time to farm this. That's the problem.
Big luxury item. Looks like he's going to be going for the Glimmer Cloak first, which is a good choice.
Yeah, for sure. That's pretty good against the Invoker, pretty good against the Lion, and just really good in terms of making it so that, you know, whoever gets the buff is just hard to kill in general, whether it be the vision problems or whether it is just dust. And yeah, this, both teams are being a little bit static at the moment, not much happening. Ogre's just running around in the jungle looking at things, dewarding.
Yeah, which team do you think this benefits more, this sort of passive farmy play?
I feel like it benefits Salt Can't Melt, still beams a bit more, but it's kind of hard to tell. Invoker has such a high lead in terms of gold. Actually, TA is now the highest net worth. I didn't notice that. TA is now highest net worth. Where did that come from? That came from somewhere. Yeah, I don't know.
She's just been farming a lot, I guess.
It's sort of a battle between Invoker and TA here, but in terms of the passive farming, it's probably go the way of the Slark lineup, because Disruptor benefits a lot from farm, and the Ogre is kind of really strange in that role. But honestly, I do somehow think, because the mech is nearly ready for Titan 3, he's, you know, 40 gold roughly away from that 30 gold now, so once he gets that, it's going to be really good. The farming does really benefit both teams, but overall I think Salt Can't Mill and Steel Beam sort of benefit that little bit extra. Clark sort of clinks, doesn't rely on farm as much, relies on kills. So in terms of position ones, it's going to go the way of the Slark lineup.
Looks like pulling the head is a sick of this passive play, and they want to take the Roche, which is, looks like it's going to just be a trade for the tier 2 top.
Yeah, definitely a nice trade for pulling ahead. Well, maybe not nice trade. That is a tier 2 tower. That's going to close down their jungle a lot, especially if there are some aggressive wards from Disruptor. He does have 2 in his inventory, so he could definitely take advantage of this. But so in terms of battles, this could go the way of pulling 4 ahead here when they do have the Aegis.
TA has picked up the Deso as well, and she's sitting on a double damage, so putting out a lot here. They do see this Invoker. Now I'm going to make the jump here.
Oh yes, Invoker. It's going to get first down, but will he die? He does die. That is
quick
some damage.
TP reaction, but just not enough there with the huge amount of damage coming out.
Ghostwalk may have been out of question considering the dust was
yeah,
just
the
used.
Dust on the Slark, so he's been carrying those around just for such occasions.
Yes, it is. I think it's a great item on Slark. But yeah, it's definitely paid off there, because he could not Ghostwalk, even if he wanted to.
Yeah, so picking off the Clinks and the Invoker, it's essential for him, so it's good that he's holding on to it. Although he doesn't have a TP, so let's hope that doesn't bite him.
Let's hope so, for his sake. And he actually is going for the Scuddy, like you said. And Slark, going down very quickly there, but he does leap away.
It's a scary thing to stand up there and hit that tier 3 when you're looking at a Doom. You're looking at the Blink Ravage from Tide.
Lion having his Blink
as
well.
Yeah, Lion Blink as well.
Adolin's on the way. Lion's actually doing... Yeah. He's not doing great in farm, but he's ahead of Disruptor by 1,000. Disruptor not having a great game in terms of farming for him.
In terms of teams, though, if we look at the graphs, both graphs, it's very, very even, close to zero, so nothing really in it right now. So pulling ahead, I've actually decided to smoke here. So off the back of losing that tower, losing Invoker, they want to make them pay for this.
They have. They
I've still got this Aegis, remember.
Look how fast Clinks is. The smoke buff, the skeleton walk buff, he is super fast,
yeah,
and he is going to be frontlining this. He is actually under a buff of his ultimate, and this is going to be some big damage here. Two hits already, and now three, four, five hits to take down Ogre, and this is actually going to be a BKB here from Clinks. He's going to take down the TA really fast. She's actually doomed up, and she's actually getting stunned here, and there is a nice Ravage from Tyler attaching this out. The mech has been popped, and Slark is by himself here, and he does actually get away with the pounce.
Disruptor's still in the neighborhood as well. Clinks is going to find him out here.
Ooh, Tornado being just short of that.
This is
he's actually getting caught out here. Clinks. What is
great
happening here?
Great play there from pulling ahead.
What is happening? This Clinks had such a bad early game, and look at him now. 8 kills. The Desolator, the BKB. That BKB definitely made a difference there.
Yeah, he was just standing there man-fighting them. So, not something you expect a Clinks to do, but he does have a fairly healthy health pool there, considering he has the BKB, which definitely helps. So
that
they're just going to hit away
fight,
at these tier 3s here. We got a buyback on TA.
TA, she still hurts quite a lot. They need to be careful with this. TA is super, super deadly at this point still, even after dying there. She actually nearly took down the Clinks when she was under the influence of Doom. She was going down nearly as... She was going down a little bit quicker than the Clinks was, so she ended up dying. But Clinks was... He was lucky to get out of there as well, I think.
I'd actually like to see...
The Silencer! He is very low. He is so close to dying.
30 health.
This is where you ask for a Sunstrike. Will he go for it? Because he does have to be careful here, Silencer.
The pings are coming out.
Is Invoker thinking of doing it? Oh, it's on cooldown.
He just used it.
Well, he missed it.
Bit
right
off the mark there. So good sense from Silencer, going into the trees for a little bit there.
Yeah, that's how you do it. You don't run in a straight line, guys. Any of you guys have been caught out by Sunstrikes all the time, don't run in a straight line.
I was just going to mention the Slark. I'd like to see him finish off the Silver Edge as well. It would make him a bit more tanky, and it can really reduce the damage output if he gets it on the right target. Also, removing passives, obviously, but probably not the biggest part of it in this game particularly.
No.
Maybe taking down the Tide might be a bit easier.
The thing is, the Tide, he can purge things off anyway with the Kraken Shell, and he also has a Guardian Greaves. So when his passives are disabled, whether it really makes a difference or not, he does have a Greaves, he does have 17 wand charges at this point anyway. I mean, this is this point in current time.
Using Shadowblade here. But also we do have to note it does reduce outgoing damage by 40%, and that includes spells as well, so
it does, yes.
Can be a huge play in a team fight.
Silver Edge is just always good to go for, really, just in terms of the buff you get, and it does maim people. It does provide a great bonus damage when you start a fight. It's just great initiation, and Slark is very good at that.
Invoker looks like he's going for a Scythe of Ice here, so getting a little bit more locked down, which they're going to have in spades after he picks that up.
Yes, they are playing very passively yet again, though. This is a very static game, but Salt Can't Melt, Steel Beam sort of wanting to end this. They are looking for that smoke gank. The Arcane Boots being popped. He is definitely going for this, but they are on the wrong side of the map here. They need to do some. They need to run a very long distance.
They may have seen this.
They do have to run a long way to get to them. Slark does also have the Shadow Blade, so he can probably frontline this in terms of scouting out. There are no sentries being dropped here as of yet. Other detection, though.
They're going to go for the pincer. Looks Doom like detection. They might actually find the Invoker on the back lines, but they run to the Doom first.
Oh, they go on the Doom. So Minus much armor taking down the Lion, actually getting 2-3 hits on this stun here. The Global Silence being caught out. The Klinks is doing so much damage. This is unbelievable. And this Slug has actually taken down as well. The BKB not helping. This is a triple kill for Slug. And the Tidehunter actually purging that off. And the Silencer is going to force stuff in, but
four
not much
down.
He can do.
Only the Disruptor still alive, and he is running for it.
This like Lion
he's gonna
was
TP
so,
out. Okay.
So low.
Wow, what a fight there. Pulling ahead. Huge gold swing. About 3,000. So,
that is,
they managed to blow up the Doom instantly, but then we saw the Ravage come out. So, that definitely helped them out in that fight. It hit probably everyone on the side of Salt.
Oh, this is that was such an important team fight, and we are going to see the Rax being committed here. The melee Rax has gone down. Can they actually stop this? Two buybacks from the Silencer and the Ogre Magi. Are they going to try and get him away with the Ignite? Can he, I mean, he might even consider popping the Greaves very soon. This Klinks is just harassing mid lane, though. They are going to go on top lane here. Lion getting the stun. Very nice Earth Spike. Will they actually take it down? The Invoker's actually used the EMP.
It's a lot
and
of damage
the
coming out.
Bit of trouble here. The Invoker's actually been silenced here by the Orchid. By the Silencer. And Klinks looking just to be a little bit too aggressive here. Will he get picked off there? This is a BKB. It's helping him out a lot here. One more attack, and the Silencer actually getting a double kill. That was some commitment to those racks.
Service
a melee,
thing is welcome.
Invoker two melee racks fell. The mid and the top melee racks. Range racks still being. Still stand.
Yeah, the Klinks is such a strong pusher, especially coupled with 50 Slater. Once they get the chance to just hit on buildings, they're going to fall very quickly.
The Sunstrike just missing this, well, actually, but just missing Disruptor was a little bit off target. And the Klinks is brought back here. He is not going to sit around and wait for his death timer.
Yeah. Bit of impatience, possibly. I don't think he had to do that, so.
Someone's pinging him. Tidehunter's pinging the Klinks to go to Roche.
It's not up. It will be in a little bit, but.
Tidehunter getting a gem here. I like that. I think he is the one to carry.
Yeah, I'm going to see TA there, but not much they can do. So. Yeah, this game's looking pretty even, but it seems to be when we have those big 5-on-5 engagements, they just seem to be going the way of pulling ahead.
Yes, the net worth difference is 12,000 gold now. It was never... This is the biggest net worth difference we have had all game. So, in terms of that, it's something to watch out for.
Yeah,
the Invoker still super far ahead.
Because there were those two big team fights, the first one in the Radiant Jungle where they took down four on the side of Salt, and then the push at the top where they actually got sort of caught out, but they still ended up winning the fight, even without the Doom.
Yeah, this is looking like a very neck and neck game, very clutch game, as we may sometimes say. This Manta, though, is still a puzzling item. I still think it is just a good item in general, but I'm just trying to look at this Manta.
He did go back for the BKB as well, so that does limit his damage a lot.
It does, but it does make it very hard to kill as well.
Could have been something else, like a Daedalus even. Looks like Roche is going to be the fight, though. Salt.
Yeah,
look like they're
not
interested.
Looking lasting long. They are interested, but they're going to be a little bit too late here. If they don't go in now, the Tornado actually getting the Slark, so that's going to slow it down. The EMP, Mana is going down. and TA blinking in, and does the Klinks actually does get it in the end. Klinks gets his town taken very, very quickly. He has no detection for him. The Ravage, this is not a hero you want to be up against in the Roche Beard. He is getting stunned here. There's a nice Earthspike line catching out Ogre, and this is Silencer going down as well. The Doom being popped on the Slark. Slark, not in a good spot. And the Roche Pit, the TA's all by herself, and she goes down to the Sunstrike.
Wow.
Five, man.
All five down. Radiant's top barracks. Fed fight at the start, it looked like it was going the way of Salt. The TA jumped in, they picked the Doom pretty quickly, but they just couldn't finish off anyone else. Kling's BKB'd and just Skeleton walked straight out of it.
Yeah.
So. And then he managed to clean up the supports on the back line, and now they're in the base.
There is a lot of creeps.
Two sets of
racks
down.
Here.
Do they go for Megas here? They've still got
they
their tier
for Megas,
2 though.
They're actually... Looks like the Klinks, he's... Yeah, no, they don't need to go for Megas. Look at this. Look at the death timers. No one's buying
back.
They
want thrown. No buybacks.
They're going to get thrown here. This Klinks, I actually cannot believe he got out of that Roach Pit alive. And the Tornado actually being thrown in the spawn, not catching out Thrall, and he is just going to sit there.
GG is the call.
That's a good game we'll play.
Pulling ahead, taking the game against Salt Can't Melt Steel Beams. So, great game, fairly even, and... Really, team fights were the ones that decided that in the end. So, that is us from Clutch Studio tonight. If you want to join us on Twitch over at ClutchNZ, you can come watch some post game analysis with me and Smoko the Top Bloco. So, we'll see you over there.
See you soon.
And we're back. So pulling ahead in terms of the rankings, so they'll be going up to about fifth position, looking very nice there for them, taking down Salt Gaming here for the Cyber Gamer Dota 2 open ladder. What'd you think of that game?
I think that was very static, but the net worth graphs were certainly super close, and it was neck and neck a lot of the game, but pulling ahead, I mean, they lost the early game. The Klinks was about, nearly 2,000 net worth behind the Slark. He was about, 30 last hits behind at one point. So the Klinks here, though, he caught up in terms of kills, and that's how he does it. But once the